Welcome back to TECHMIMIC, where you can simply view, imitate, replicate, and get on with your day. If there is a specific issue for which you would like to see a video, please leave a comment. On Linux Mint 22, when trying to run a sudo command as your regular user, you ran into this error. Let's try it when installing a packet. User is not allowed to execute as root or running any other command with sudo. When you install a brand new Linux Mint 22 and create the normal user account during installation, sudo works out of the box and the user is part of the sudo group by default. If you can't use sudo, it could be that your user account is not in the sudo group, which will prevent you from running sudo commands. Check this with the groups command. Indeed, the group sudo is not listed here. Now, normally we would simply switch to the root user to fix this issue. Again, after a fresh installation, and by default, sudo uses your own user account password to run a command as a root user. So the same password as you use to log in to Linux Mint. Trying to switch to the root via the su or su-dash command will result in an authentication failure, because by default on Linux Mint there is no password set for root. That's why your normal user account is in the sudo group by default and you can just use your own password. Despite the root having no password set, if you don't type anything, it also doesn't work because the password is not nothing, it's just not set. If you have ever set your root password manually, you would have to type that here, but that is not the default. The easiest way to become root is to use the sudo-i command. As mentioned, this allows you to become root with your own password. But in this case, we have seen that you can't run sudo commands, so we have to find another method. But despite all of this, if we can't use sudo-i or su, how do we get into the system as root in this situation? During research, I've seen quite a few articles where you would need to boot from a live USB and use advanced startup options. And those can all be valid in particular situations. But here, it can be easily done with your existing Linux Mint installation and good finger timing. You will see what I mean by that shortly. Restart the machine, or maybe shut it down completely and start it again if you can't get to the menu that I will explain now. And while it starts, hold down the Shift key to access the startup menu. This might take a few attempts, but maybe you are lucky on the first shot. Eventually, you should end up with the Linux Mint startup menu. And from this menu, select the default boot option. By default, that will be Linux Mint 22 Cinnamon. Adjust in your case if necessary. And once it is selected, don't press Enter, but press E for Edit, to edit the configuration before booting. Now a text editor appears and navigate to the line that starts with Linux and remove RO quiet splash. And type RW init equals /bin/bash. Once done, press F10 or Ctrl X to start Linux Mint with the adjusted options and you will be dropped straight into a command line as root, but without the need to type a password. Mount the file system with the command mount-o remount, rw space forward slash. And finally reset the root password with the command passwd root. And provide a new password and retype it. That's it. Now your root password has been reset. Note that if someone would have physical access to your Linux machine, you can now see how easy it is to gain access as a root user. Reboot the machine with the command exec /sbin/init. Now Linux Mint will be started as normal. Log in as your normal user, and to fix the issue that your user account can't run sudo commands, type su and provide the root password that you have just set. Now add your user to the sudo group with the command usermod-a G sudo and then your username. And to refresh all the group memberships, it's easiest to just restart the machine a last time and log in again. Check the group membership with the command groups and the sudo group is now listed and you should now be able to use sudo commands. earlier commands that failed with the user not allowed to execute as root error will now run without problems. Going forward, sudo -i will now work again too, which is the easiest method if you would need a dedicated root shell instead of individual sudo commands. That's it, hope it helped, and if it did, please like the video and keep it up. Until next time, bye!